depression and rehabilitation, which is the major causes of complications that cause morbidity and mortality. While infection are the result of community exposure transmitted with aggregate inactivation in the setting of immunosuppression, a model of simultaneous infection aside from virus mechanism simultaneous with herbicide exhaustive infection. The effect of viral infection can be classified into a direct effect and indirect effect. Direct effects patients present with fever, neutropenia, invasive disease, pneumonia, meningitis, encephalitis, or indirect effect through the release of cytokines and chemokines that increase the risk of other opportunistic infection, may change the expression of surface antigen and provoking direct rejection or causing dysregulated cellular proliferation, and increase the viral replication and resistance may lead to allograft injury or chronic rejection. The pre-transplant screening of both organic donors and recipients is essential. Why? To identify the condition which may disqualify either donor or recipient, identify and treat active infection in pre-transplant, define the risk of infection, and define the strategy of preventing post-transplant infection, and to implement preventive measure interventions as update for vaccination schedule. The donor-derived infection can be classified into expected and unexpected. The expected donor infection that patient when doing a screening for this patient should respond the patient had a seropositive donor to a seronegative recipient. This is the expected donor infection and can be prevented by prophylactic strategy after transplantation. The unexpected donor derived infection when the screening serology is negative and the patient in the window phase either in hepatitis C or B and HIV infection. So the serology would give a false negative and the patient has an infection. The risk of post-transplant infection can be decreased by donor and recipient evaluation, including history, clinical, social, and behavioral and traumatic history, physical examination, serology, and microbiology testing, and should be performed in all donors and recipients for some pathogens. HIV, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, cytomegalovirus, and Epstein-Barr virus are the most important viral infection to be screened for. The cytomegalovirus may result from a reactivation of latent infection or primary infection transmitted by a kidney from a cytomegalovirus to the tumor. Symptoms appear in 20-60% of all the transplant recipients, and serology screening for antibody to cytomegalovirus should be performed in both donor and recipient for transplantation. When we use a serological test for cytomegalovirus by cluster collecting agglutination test, we found that the cytomegalovirus will do IgM and IgG. Seronegative is IgM negative and IgG negative. Zero positive, IgM negative and IgG positive. If the IgM is positive, the patient has acute infection of cytomegalovirus. We found that most of the people who have a cytomegalovirus with IgG positive as a seropositive patients, except immediately we have IgG negative also. The cytomegalovirus donor positive and recipient is at high risk for cytomegalovirus infection post transplantation. And cytomegalovirus seropositive recipient will develop a disease reactivation or donor related infection. Therefore, organ donors and recipients should be tested for cytomegalovirus by ELISA to stop the risk assessment and antiviral prophylaxis after transplantation. As the laboratory methods for cytomegalovirus diagnosis, serology, culture, and molecular methods by uric acid testing, which is the most common performed using the real-time memorized machine reaction. The Epstein-Barr virus, the second virus which is very important, infection of Epstein-Barr virus is present with asymptomatic viremia or infectious mucoses or at least post-transplant proliferative disorders. We do a serological screening for the Epstein-Barr virus by ELISA and should be performed in both donors and recipients before transplantation. Epstein-Barr virus is negative by IgM negative and IgG negative, and it also IgM negative and IgG positive. So finally, Epstein-Barr virus infection of hepatitis B, Epstein-Barr virus negative recipients may lead to infected organs and maybe to infected organs from the recipient from the donor, out transmission of latent Epstein-Barr virus infected blood donor lymphocytes. These patients which have Epstein-Barr virus negative recipients have increased risk to have a primary infection, this increases risk of developing Epstein-Barr virus associated neuroproliferative disorders. The cause of high prevalence of latent Epstein-Barr virus infection is the adult population with a retest or positive test of Epstein-Barr virus IgG from 90 to 95%, except in children when they have Epstein-Barr virus negative. is the first response following transplantation. And the immediate recipient in children are at risk of primary infection if exposed to the acquired testosterone, which can result in sleep and giving fetal infection. So they should be vaccinated before transplantation. First of all, complications for cellulose include pneumonitis, hepatitis, and encephalitis. A pre-transplant serology should be obtained from herpes zoster virus 1 and virus 2 and Bersella zoster, and strategies for prevention have been identified for other herpes virus, adenovirus herpes virus 6 and 7 and 8, but there is no recommendation for at this time for the ratio of seropositive to seronegative. This piece of paper was published in April 2017 about the prevalence of cytomegalovirus in donors and opportunistic viral infection. They found that the presence of herpes zoster virus 1 and 2 was high after transplantation, and the reactivation of cytomegalovirus and Epstein-Barr virus was very low in response to high incidence of the infection of herpes zoster virus 1 and 2. In the good paper in published paper in 2015 as a group of screening of herpes zoster virus in candidate for organ transplantation, and they recommended to avoid cremation from seropositive donor to seronegative donors. But this paper was limited by the added amount of people for transplantation, it was around 37 people. Hepatitis B virus, it can be transmitted by water to the organ transplantation. Recognize the hepatitis B virus infection, you get de novo infection or reactivation of a previous resolved infection. Serological tests should be done for both donor and recipient. Donor and recipient screening should include at least hepatitis B surface antigen, hepatitis B core antibody IgM and IgG. Donors who have hepatitis B surface antigen positive or hepatitis B core antibody positive indicates that the patient has active infection of hepatitis B. And an isolated hepatitis B surface antibody indicates that the patient has a previous vaccination or resolved infection, and there is no risk for hepatitis B transmission, so this patient can be transplanted. The donor recipient can donate and give to the recipient. Hepatitis B surface antigen negative and hepatitis B core antibody positive may be in the window period, and such donor have not been utilized until now. And some centers have used this donor to patients with hepatitis B surface antibody with intensive post-transplant prophylaxis and monitoring. So the problem with the patient is hepatitis B surface antigen negative and hepatitis B core antibody positive. This core positive donor may present a false positive or a resistant hepatitis B infection. In hepatic transplantation, the risk of transmission is very high. But in the non-hepatic transplantation, the recipient may have a low risk, but not a zero, to have hepatitis B. So, when we collect this, the patient is not a B-cell antigen negative or antibody negative hepatitis B surface antibody positive, so there is no risk for transplantation. Patient is not a B-cell antigen positive or hepatitis B or IgM positive, this is a high risk. Patient is not a B or positive IgM, this is a high risk, as it should be in the very window period. Patient is hepatitis B or IgG, this is a low risk. So, with patients with hepatitis B or IgG, with them, have low risk. To manage this risk, we should pre-transplant hepatitis B virus vaccination and use prophylaxis or use prophylaxis with hepatitis B immunoglobulins. All the seronegative transplant recipients should have hepatitis B vaccine that requires higher precision of the immune structure. The hepatitis B surface antibody positive recipient should not require prophylaxis. The period of time for this surface antigen most stable was considered a contraindication of non-hepatic transplantation. With more effective therapy now, the patient with hepatitis B surface antigen positive donor require a patient for at least 12 weeks as a treatment duration, will most likely show the same virus response before initial positive. We should note that all the donor candidates should undergo serological testing for HCV and hepatitis C infection as close as possible to the date of the organ recovery, but with no longer than 28 days before initiation, because it always that time increase that when to give the investigation is going to get. HIV or immune deficiency requires all donor candidates should undergo microbiology testing for HIV infection as close as possible to the date of organ for no longer than 28 days before initiation. And HIV infection is also indicated to organ donation which IV recipient as a transmission of HIV, actually HIV negative recipient as a transmission of HIV by organ transplantation. To detect HIV, we should do antibodies genetic against HIV antigen, direct detection of viral nucleic acid testing of HIV antigen. By the answer, the antibody of HIV can be detected, but it should be confirmed by this report, immune blood testing. And the donor, maybe who have a high risk for HIV, should do nucleic acid testing. The donor may be assuming a wide range of infection, nucleic acid testing should can reduce the risk. Many countries have a policy and regulation that prohibits the organ donation for HIV infected person, but recently in South Africa, they make a donation of HIV infected organ for HIV infected kidney recipients. The HIV infected patient receiving renal transplant may meet a high risk of acute rejection because the measurement of immunosuppression in HIV infected individual remains unknown. They may be linked to the activation of the HIV. The increased donors can be interviewed for hepatitis B, C, and HIV. The serological test can detect the infection highly effective in reducing the risk of infection post transplantation, but the serum conversion, the antibody, may have a time delay, maybe it is just a few weeks between the infection and the serological antibody. So, the British Transplantation Society put a strategy that we need to create estimating the volume of the testing results. When hepatitis B, the serological test can detect the hepatitis B virus in hepatitis expansion 35 to 45 days, but the nucleic acid testing can decrease the window period 20 to 22 days. The HCV, 70 days, the serology can detect it, but the nucleic acid testing may reduce it to 3 to 5 days. HIV, the HIV antibody can be detected within 17 to 22 days after infection, but the nucleic acid testing may reduce it to decrease the window period to 5 to 6 days. The critical time and commitment to the evaluation of living donors that are recommended, all the potential organ donors should be tested for antibody to HIV, and all organ donors identified as being high risk or increased risk of HIV infection should be to HIV by RNA environment acid testing. Both antibody, both recipient and donor should do anti HCV antibody and HCV RNA environment acid testing, hepatitis B core antibody and hepatitis B surface antigen, and they recommended that the serology should be done as soon as possible before the transplantation, but with no longer than 28 days before surgery. Donors who have hepatitis C and hepatitis B virus infection are not at risk of transplantation except if they have acute infection of hepatitis C or hepatitis E at the time of the transplantation. The recommendation for screening of donor and recipient, they recommended to do HIV antibody, cytomegaly virus antibody, Epstein-Barr virus antibody, IG, hepatitis B surface antigen, hepatitis B core antibody, and HCV antibody. Thank you.